what is the biggest man's problem today? Alam mo ninyo, there's a lot of problem coming into every people, every family, every one of us. Pero ano po ba talaga ang problema ng tao? Well, there's a problem na dumarating sa buhay ng mga tao about relationship, about love life, about finances, about health, and a problem about economy, you know, about their business, different problems coming into everyone. Pero ano ba ang pinakamalalang problema po ng tao? Sa panahon natin ngayon, alam po natin na debt is spreading out all over the world. Isa pong nakakalungkot po na balita ang mga nababalitaan nating kabi-kabila sa oras na ito o sa mga araw na ito, no? Na yung pong mga kakilala natin, mga kaibigan natin, yung iba kamag-anak natin ay bigla na lang natin na babalitaan na umuwi na kay Lord. So minsan parang hindi ka panipaniwala kasi ang lakas naman niya, ano? Yung iba naman ay hindi natin akalain na yun na pala yung oras nila. At pagtitingnan natin, napakasimple lang yung mga sakit. Parang simpleng trangkaso lang, and yet bigla na lang nabalitaan natin na umuwi na kay Lord. At ang pinakamasakit pa dito ay hindi na natin nakita yung kanila pong mga katawan. Lumabas, abo na lang. And this problem that is spreading out all over the world nowadays are, you know, joining all the wisdom and the strength of all nations all over the world to solve this problem. The problem of spreading out of debt. Kaya lahat ng mga matatalino, lahat ng mga doktor nagsama-sama. Kaya lang pati yung mga doktor na ating pong inaasahan na makakatulong sa atin ay tinatamaan din. At isang bukas na katotohanan na marami na po ang umuwi na rin kay Lord. So, paano natin masusolusyonan yung mga bagay na ito? Okay? So, the problem now is debt. Debt. That is the big problem of the world nowadays. Kaya lahat tayo ay pupwedeng tamaan yan. But I do believe lahat po ng mga nakikinig po ngayon, we are all protected by the blood of Jesus. We are all in a safe place. We have a refuge. And we are in the bosoms of our Father in heaven. We are protected by His love. Amen? Praise God. So let's pray before we go to the message of God. Father, thank you that the Holy Spirit is with us to give us a word of enlightenment, word of encouragement, Lord, a word of life for us to understand the reality of life. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for touching every hearts tonight and opening their mind, especially their loved ones, Father God, na makakarinig ng mensaheng ito upang nang sa ganon, we can entrust everything to you. At ikaw lang ang magiging pag-asa namin sa buhay na ito. Thank you in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Glory to the name of the Lord. Okay, so how death entered the world? Bakit nga ba dumating ang kamatayan? Ang sabi po ng Romans chapter 5 verse 12, when Adam sinned, the entire world was affected. So, napakalaki po ang epekto ng kasalanan na nagawa po ng ating unang magulan. So, sin entered human experience and death was the result. And so, death followed the sin, casting its shadow over all humanity because all have sinned. So, dito po sa Romans chapter 5 verse 12 ay ipinaliwanag po ni Apostol Pablo na ang dahilan kung bakit pong merong kamatayan. Actually, death is not only about the stop of breathing of man, kundi even poverty is death. Everything that is in darkness is death, no? Yung pong sakit at karamdaman, that is death. Yung pong kawalan o kahirapan, that is death. Yung pong pamumuhay sa magulong pamumuhay, that is also a result of sin or death, no? Everything that is in darkness is death. At dumating ang mga bagay na ito because of sin that was entered in. Okay, take note. Sin entered into this world. And that is the reason why this darkness, this death, this patayan dito, patayan doon, kahirapan dito, kahirapan doon, lahat ng mga bagay na nangyayari ngayon sa mundo ay resulta po yan ng kasalanan. At ang sabi nga po ng Romans chapter 6 verse 23, the wages of sin is death. At ang pinakamatindi dito na sinasabi po ng Bible is all of us, all of human race are fall short. We are all sinned before God. So kaya ang katawan nating lupa ay tinatamaan po ng sakit at karamdaman at marami pong mga iba't iba pong uri ng problema ang dumarating po sa buhay po ng tao. At this sin that came into this world ay nagpahiwalay po sa atin. So this is the big problem, no? Alam po natin na kapag ang tao po ay napawalay sa Diyos, ay nagkakaroon po siya ng pamumuhay, no? Dali lang. Parang maingay, ano? Maingay po sa aking monitor. Dali lang. I am distracted. Okay, so let us continue. Sin separate man from God. Isaiah 59 verse 2, sabi niya, your iniquities have separated you from your God and your sins have hidden His face from you so that He will not hear. So makikita po natin dito na napakatindi po ang epekto ng kasalanan na pumasok sa mundo. Sin actually is not about what you did that is wrong, kundi sin that was entered in. Meaning, this is a noun. This is a person. It was entered into a man that causes death to every one of us. And this is a big problem. You know, God doesn't want everyone to live in this kind of darkness. Kaya ang Diyos po ay nagpakita po ng solusyon sa atin, ano? At ito po yung dapat na maintindihan ng lahat ng taong nabubuhay sa ibabaw ng mundo. We must know the solution of God for this problem of man. And you know what's the solution of God? We can know all of this verse, no? This verse that I'm going to read to you in John chapter 3 verse 16. Wow. Do you know this verse? Well, if you are a Christian, you must know this verse. This verse is the very heart of God. This is the very love of God. Ang sabi nga po sa Espanyol ay ito, porque de tal manera amo Dios al mundo para asuhiyo alago ni nito a todo aquel que en el cree no si pierda, mas tinga viva eterna. Wow. What does it mean? For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son. You know, God so loved this world. God so loved you dearly. Dito po sa Amplified Version, for God so greatly loved and dearly prized the world that He even gave up His only begotten unique Son, so that whoever believes in, trusts in, clings to Him, relies on Him, shall not perish, but come or shall not come to destruction, shall not be lost, but have eternal, everlasting life. Wow. You know, the very solution for the problem that enters into this world is all about the love of God, the love of the Lord. You must receive this love, this great, unconditional, beyond explanation, beyond the reach of our thinking, the love of our Father. At ano po ang naging bunga itong pag-ibig na ito? He gave His only begotten Son as a payment for our sin. Kapatid, the problem that we are now facing, the problem that is now destroying the world, destroying people, has already been solved. We must see this solution that God gave unto us. And the very solution is no other than our Lord Jesus Christ. Now, paano ba maligtas, ano? How can a man be saved? How can a man be saved? There's a man na lumapit sa ating Panginoong Jesucristo. How could I, what shall I do to inherit eternal life? Sabi ng isang mayaman, ano? Alam po ninyo, nung sinabi ng Panginoon Jesucristo yung dapat niyang gawin, to make the long story short, ay siya po ay nalungkot na lumayo sa ating Panginoon. At ang sabi ng ating Panginoon Jesucristo sa kanyang mga alagad ay mas madali pa. It is more easier for a camel to enter into the eye of a needle than a rich man to enter in the kingdom of God. Alam po ninyo, nagtaka yung mga alagad. Ang tanong nila sa Matthew chapter 19 verse 25, when the disciples heard it, they were greatly astonished, saying, "Who then can be saved?" Sino kayo na maliligtas? But you know, when Jesus looked at them and said to them, "With men this is impossible, but with God all things are possible." Ang gusto pong ipaabot ng Lord dito sa salitang ito ay hindi kayang gawin ng tao ang kaligtasan. With men, this is impossible. Salvation with men is impossible, but with God, all things are possible. You know, again, the result of sin coming into this world is destruction, death, poverty, brokenness, every darkness that is happening in the lives of people. But, you know, there is already a solution, and we must receive this solution. So we must believe in our Lord Jesus Christ. Yan po ang solusyon na pinagkaloob sa atin ng Panginoon. So believe it or not, we must believe and you receive eternal life. In John chapter 3 verse 17, sabi rito, God did not send the Son into the world to judge and condemn the world. That is, to initiate the final judgment of the world. But that the world might be saved through Him. Through Him, through our Lord Jesus Christ. Ito ngayon yung solusyon ng ating Panginoon Jesucristo. Whoever believes and has decided to trust in Him as personal Savior and Lord is not judged. For this one, there is no judgment, no rejection, no condemnation if you believe in our Lord Jesus Christ. But the one who does not believe and has decided to reject Him as personal Savior and Lord is judged already. That one has been convicted and sentenced because he has not believed and trusted in the name of the one and only begotten Son of God. The one who is truly unique, the only one of his kind, the one who alone can save him. Dito po sa verse na ito, sa Amplified Version ng John chapter 3 verse 17 and 18, ang tanging solusyon upang matanggap po natin ang ibinigay ng Diyos na solusyon upang tayo po ay magkaroon ng buhay na ganap at kasiyasiya at masolusyonan po ang kamatayan na lumalaganap sa buong mundo, masolusyonan ang kahirapan, masolusyonan ang lahat ng mga gawa ng kadiliman is we need to believe in His Son Jesus Christ. It's not a religion. Religion is all about a teaching, or they will teach you how to do something good in your own performance to receive the blessing of the Lord. But dito po sa tinuturo natin at sinasabi ng ating Panginoon si Kristo ay we need to believe and receive our Lord Jesus Christ. As sabi nga po sa John chapter 3 verse 36, he who believes and trusts in the Son and accept him as Savior has eternal life. That is, already possesses it. So once you believe in Him and trust Him on what He did at the cross, you already have eternal life. But he who does not believe the Son and chooses to reject Him, disobeying Him and denying Him as a Savior, will not see eternal life. Ito po yung nakakatakot. But instead, the wrath of God hangs over him continually. Wow, actually that's not good news, no? That's not good news that the wrath of God hangs over to everyone who don't receive and believe our Lord Jesus Christ as the Lord and Savior. I just want to preach the good news. Pero, isa pong katotohanan that if you reject Jesus as the payment for your sin, Jesus Christ as the solution for your problem right now, because the main problem of people is not about money, the main problem of people is not about your relationship, it's not about what is lacking in your home, lacking in your house tonight, kundi yung pong wala kang buhay na wala hanggan, or you are living in a separate life from God. That is the best or the big problem ever. Okay? At ako po'y naniniwala, lahat po ng mga nakikinig ngayon, you already received Christ as your Lord and Savior. And because of that, you have peace now in your heart. You now have that heart, a peaceful heart every day to live continuously praising God, worshiping God, and thanking God for your life. And of course, sharing this good news, the only way for salvation to all your loved ones. No? Those who believe will confess Jesus is Lord. Do you believe Christ as your Lord and Savior? Do you now receive Him as your Lord and Savior? If yes, you are confessing Jesus continuously. As sabi nga po dito sa Romans chapter 10 verse 9, because of if you acknowledge and confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord, meaning recognizing His power, authority, and majesty as God, if you confess and acknowledge what He did at the cross, that is the only means for you and for us to be saved, and you believe that He is Lord. Pag sinabing Lord, He is the owner of you, He is the owner of everything, He is the master, He is the captain, okay? And even king, because the Lord is also a king. And you believe in your heart that God raised Him from the dead, you will be saved, sabi ni Pablo. At ito, napakaganda po sa verse 10, ano, dito sa Amplified Version. For with the heart a person believes, you know, you are believing in your heart, in Christ as a Savior, resulting in His justification. Alam po ninyo, wala pa po tayong ginagawa. You just believe. You don't need to do something for you to be justified or for your sin to be taken away. There's only one thing that we must do, and that is believe. Believing in your heart. You believe that all of Christ did at the cross is more than enough, that your sins has been taken away, your sins has been paid off. At ang tao pong naniniwala sa kanyang puso, sa lahat ng ginawa ng ating Panginoong Kristo sa cross, ay punong-puno ng pasasalamat at pagpupuri sa Diyos. At you know what? Once you believe in your heart, wala ka pang ginawa, you are already justified. You are already declared not guilty, declared righteous in the sight of God, and because you believe, sabi po rito sa verse natin, ay you also confess with your mouth. Kaya, with the heart a person believes, resulting in his justification, that is being made righteous, being freed of the guilt of sin and made acceptable to God. And with the mouth, he acknowledges and confesses. The word confesses here is continuously speaking it out, continuously sharing what you are believing. So if you believe that Christ died at the cross and He is the Lord of your life, hallelujah, you're justified. You are already made righteous and freed from the guilt of sin. And you are made acceptable to God. Oh, hallelujah, I tell you. If this reality become alive in your heart, you're gonna praise the Lord all the days of your life. At wala na tayong katatakutan. At dahil itong ang pinapaniwalaan natin, with your mouth, you acknowledge and confess His faith openly, sabi niya, resulting in and confirming His salvation. Kaya yung pong naniniwala sa kanyang puso, sa ating Panginoon, ay nagpapahayag. Alam mo ninyo, nung ako po ay nakakilala sa Lord, wala na akong ibang hangarin pa, kundi ang ipahayag ang mabuting mabalita, higit sa lahat unang-una sa aking mga kamag-anakan, sa aking mga mahal sa buhay. Kaya lahat po ng mga nakikinig ngayon, in all means, in all ways, you have to declare Jesus to all your loved ones. Lalong-lalo na kung kayo po ang breadwinner. Pakikinggan nila kayo. At kinakailangan with passion, with wholeheartedly, sapagkat ang taong wala kay Kristo, whether you like it or not, when they will die separately from God. And if a person dies separated from God, you know, they will live in a place of darkness. They will live in a place that there is no attributes of God. A place of punishment. A place of darkness. At wala nang magagawa pa kapag ang tao ay namatay, nawala si Kristo sa kanyang buhay. Kaya nga po, bago maging huli ang lahat, this is now the time to share God's word to them. Share Jesus to them. You know, salvation or eternal life is a gift. You don't need to earn for it, no? Alam natin yan. At sana maging malinaw sa atin yan. Kasi ako, nung una akong manampalataya, although ako'y nagpapasalamat sa pag-ibig ni Lord, kaya lang dahil hindi naging malinaw sa akin, it seems like I have to work for my salvation. But you don't need to work for your salvation. You just need to work out your salvation. Working for and working out are different. Working for means na gumagawa ka para maligtas. Gumagawa ka ng isang mabuting bagay para makamtan ng kaligtasan. But that's not the right word. The right word is you are working out, meaning you already have that salvation, you already have eternal life, and you working it out, ibig sabihin, nabubuhay ka na naipapakita sa tao yung buhay na merong relasyon sa Diyos. That is working out your salvation. Eternal life is a gift, sabi rito sa Romans 6:23, the wages of sin is death, but the free gift of God, that is His remarkable, overwhelming gift of grace to believers, is eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord. Oh glory! Hallelujah! This is a gift. Pag sinabing gift, hindi mo kayang o hindi galing sa'yo. At bakit regalo ang buhay na walang hanggan? Sapagkat walang taong sino man tao na pupwedeng maka-gain nito sa pamamagitan ng kanyang sariling effort. Kaya nga po, iniriregalo ito ng Diyos sa atin. Pag sinabi namang regalo, this is free. Okay? Libre ito. At hindi ibig sabihin na libre ay mumurahin, cheap, kundi ito po ay mamahalin. We cannot provide salvation or eternal life in our own. At hindi rin tayo makakabili kahit saan. Ang sabi rito sa Ephesians 2:8-9, it is by grace, meaning God's remarkable compassion and favor drawing you to Christ that you have been saved, actually delivered from judgment and given eternal life through faith. And this salvation is not of yourselves. So mga liwanag, no? This salvation is not of yourselves, not through your own effort, but it is the undeserved gracious gift of God. Not as a result of your works, nor your attempts to keep the law, so that no one will be able to boast or take credit in any way for his salvation. Again, salvation, eternal life, is a gift from the Lord. So we must share this gift to all people. Ito yung pinakamagandang regalo na maibibigay natin sa lahat ng ating mga mahal sa buhay at kamag-anakan. Ang ibahagi sa kanila si Kristo, sapagkat si Kristo ang buhay na walang hanggan, si Kristo ang regalo na pupwede nating ibigay na pinakamaganda, sapagkat yan po ang pinakamagandang regalo na natanggap natin sa ating Panginoon. And when you receive this gift of eternal life, this gift of salvation, our Lord Jesus Christ, you already pass from death to life. And you already have that eternal life, kaya wala na tayong katatakutan pa, wala ng pandemya, wala ng virus, wala ng krisis na po pwede pang sumupil sa atin. Kaya nga po, whatever things happening in this world, we are secured and we have joy and happiness because we know that we have a very good God. Whatever things happening, we are safe. Amen. Glory to God. And if you already have that eternal life or salvation, you be at peace now. Have that assurance of salvation. Lahat ba dito ay meron ng kasiguruhan sa kaligtasan? I tell you, once you receive Christ, be at peace. Just live a life of praising God. Just live a life of giving thanks to God every day. Just live a life of peace. Just live a life of, full of hope and happiness, joy in your heart now. Don't be scared. Don't worry. And huwag matakot sa anumang pong mga balita na nangyayari sa buong mundo. And don't even scared for the mark of the beast. Don't even scared for the 666. Don't even scared for the vaccine. No? Don't even scared for whatever things happening in this world. Why? Because you are already sealed by the Holy Spirit. Once you have Christ in your life, you already have eternal life. You are now secured in the hands of God. You are God's property. You belong to God. You are acceptable to God. And the Lord loves you already. Amen? Praise God! 1 John 5:11, the testimony is this: God has given us eternal life, who already possesses it. And this life is in His Son, resulting in our spiritual completeness and eternal companionship with Him. Wow, praise the Lord. This life is in His Son, Jesus Christ. And we receive Christ as Lord and Savior. Ang sabi dito, nagre-resulta ng spiritual completeness natin and eternal companionship with Him. He who has the Son, by accepting Him as Lord and Savior, has the life that is eternal. He who does not have the Son of God, by personal faith, does not have the life. Friend, in verse 13, 1 John chapter 5, these things I have written to you who believe in the name of the Son of God, sabi po ni John, which represents all that Jesus Christ is and does, so that you will know with settled and absolute knowledge that you already have eternal life. Praise the name of Jesus. You can write it there. I have already eternal life. Pag sinabing meron ka ng buhay na walang hanggan, wala ka ng kamatayan. At hindi na kayang supilin pa, hindi na kayang patayin pa ng anumang pandemya, anumang pong crisis, anumang virus, anumang pong COVID, ang buhay na walang hanggan na meron ka ngayon. Kaya, be at peace. Whatever things happening, there's no work of the devil that can destroy the life of God that is in you now. So this is God's solution. This is the only solution. Salamat sa mga doktor, salamat sa mga gamot, salamat sa vaccine na kanila pong ini-implement sa ngayon. But that is not our protection. Thank you for the life of all our doctors and medical personnels. Thank you for the life of our government officials na nag-iisip kung ano at paano masolusyonan ang problema sa mundong ito. Salamat sa mga ekonomista. Pero alam po ninyo, ang tanging solusyon sa buong mundo, sa problema ng mundong ito, ay walang iba kundi ang ating Panginoong Hesukristo. Christ is the answer of all man's problem. So you must share this truth to all your friends, to all your loved ones, my friends. And again, just have peace in your heart. If you have Jesus Christ, then you already have eternal life. You possess abundance. You possess salvation. Salvation means not just having eternal life when you get to when you depart from this world, but salvation means you already have the perfect health, divine health in your body. Oh, hallelujah! Praise God for that. You know, there is judgment. There is judgment coming in. Sabi ng Hebrew chapter 9 verse 27, it is appointed for men to die once. But after this, the judgment. We will all face the Lord anytime from now. Alam po ninyo, nakakalungkot po na yung mga ibang mga kakilala natin pumasok sa ospital, paglabas, abo na. Para bang hindi natin kayang tanggapin minsan. Pero alam po ninyo, on the other side to those people or loved ones na tumanggap na sa ating Panginoong Hesukristo, we are rejoicing, although there is loneliness in our heart kasi hindi na natin sila makita physically, but we know their destiny. They are now in heaven. They are now in enjoying heaven with the Lord and seeing Jesus face to face. At ito pong pinakamaganda, tayo pong mga naiwan, we need to have an assurance in our heart and peace. Sapagkat alam natin anuman po ang pangyayari sa mundong ito, glory to God, we have eternal life and no one can destroy that life that is in us. Ang sabi nga po ng Romans chapter 8 verse 1, there is now no condemnation, no guilty verdict, no punishment for those who are in Christ Jesus, who believe Him in Him as personal Lord and Savior. Hallelujah! Glory to God! I like that word. Now no condemnation, no guilty verdict, no punishment, no judgment for those who are in Christ Jesus, who believe in Him as personal Lord and Savior. Praise God! So when we face the Lord, our judgment is this: you are not guilty. You are righteous. Come and enjoy life eternal in My kingdom. Amen! Praise God! So this is God's solution to man's problem. At sa lahat po ng mga nakikinig ngayon na hindi pa po nakakatanggap at nagko-confess ng kanyang pananampalataya sa Panginoong Jesus, just say this prayer. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for loving me. Thank you that you died at the cross to pay my sin. I believe in you. I receive you as Lord and Savior of my life. Come into my life. From now on, you are my King. You are my Lord. I thank you for the forgiveness of my sin. I thank you for the eternal life. I love you, Lord, because you first loved me. In Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Glory to the name of Jesus.